Hello, welcome to Accounting Hub. I'm Professor George Scarpin, PhD in Accounting, and our topic today is current liabilities, short-term notes payable. So first of all, what is it? What is short-term notes payable? The characteristics of short-term notes payables are temporary financing from bank. Promissory note is signed, lower interest rates than long-term debit because you will pay it faster, so you pay lower interest rates, and companies have flexibility while selecting financial alternatives. This is the characteristics here in the United States. If you are in other countries, maybe these interest rates, they are not the same way, but that is how it works here in the US. However, the first one, it is all over the place. Temporary financing from bank, because they are short-term notes payable. And remember, short-term is below 12 months or below the operating cycle of a company. Which one is the longer? Okay, so usually we are working with financing from anything below 12 months, below 1 year. Okay. And when we are talking about notes payable, and this is the most important difference between accounts payable and notes payable. Accounts payable, we have no interest. Notes payable, notes signed by a firm promising to repay the amount plus interest. And interest is calculated as face value times annual rate times fraction of the year. And again, this interest rate is in the U.S. If you are not in the U.S., check your country about this fraction of the year. Sometimes they have different formula for that, okay? So let's go to our Excel file. And all our Excel files, they are free to download it. And the link is in our video description. So let me delete these numbers here. And let me delete this one here. And we can go. On November 1st, Scarpin Corporation, my fake company, borrowed $500,000 cash from Santiago Bank. Santiago is the last name of my wife. Under a non-committed short-term line of credit arrangement and issue a 6 months. So 6 months. We are talking about short term. 12% promissory note. So we are talking about notes payable. And interest was payable at maturity. So only after 6 months. So, okay, November 1st, December 1st, January 1st, February 1st, March, and April 1st. So we will pay it on May 1st, 6 months. Accounting is easy. Counting how many months, that is the harder topic, as I always tell to my students. So here we will pay on May 1st the principal plus interest. So what is our journal entry? November 1st, cash, debit cash, $500,000. Credit, notes payable. The other $500,000. However, we are on December 31st. We need to accrue all this interest because here we are ending our year. We need to prepare our financial statement. So how do we accrue it? Interest expense, interest payable. How much? We are talking about November, December. 2 months. So 500,000 times 12%. However, 12% is the interest per year. When we don't mention here the period, we assume that is per year. So divided by 12, and we will find it in 1 month, times 2, that is for 2 months. And $10,000. And again, it is in the US. Sometimes in other countries, this formula for the interest, it is a little bit different. So check your country legislation about it, Okay? So interest expense and interest payable, $10,000. And now on May 1st, we will pay it. So what are we paying? Notes payable, $500,000. We are paying the interest payable as well. So this interest payable, we are also paying them. And we still need to pay 4 months of interest. So interest expense, 500 times 12% divided by 12 times 4. Another $20,000, and we will pay it. So credit cash, how much? The sum of all of this number, 530. How do we double check if it is right or wrong? So double check. What are we paying? 500 times 12% or plus interest plus 500 times 12% divided by 12 times 6 months. So we are paying 530. The 530 here. Okay. However, sometimes we don't have the interest. And how do we do that? That is the non-interest bearing note. So this first one, we call it note issued for cash. The second one is non-interest bearing note. Usually when we are purchasing some inventory or other assets besides cash. But cash. So, how do we do that? Oh, come on. On November 1st, the same Skyping Corporation, my fake company, bought inventory worth 452 by issuing a 500,000 non-interest bearing note due in 6 months. So, okay, we are purchasing inventory. The cash price is 452. However, I will pay it 6 months later, so I will pay $500,000. So we have interest here. The interest is hidden, but we have. So how do we do that? Our debit inventory, how much? 452. That is the real selling price of my inventory, or the real purchase price of my inventory. That is the cash price. And what is our credit? Notes payable, $500,000. However, it is not balanced. We need to balance this journal entry. How do we balance it? Discount on notes payable, a contra account of notes payable, and it is the difference between inventory and notes payable. So this is the discount on notes payable. And again, the same here, December 31st, we have our interest. So interest, expense, and our credit is the same discount on notes payable. How much? We have no percentage here. How do we work on that? This 48,000, it is for 6 months. How much it would be if it was for 2 months only? So 48 divided by 6, we have our discount per month. Times 2, we have our discount for 2 months. So $16,000. May 1st, we are paying it. What we are paying? Notes payable, 500,000. Oh, so first of all, what is easy? First of all, let's close the discount on notes payable. Because if you are paying our notes payable, we have no more discount. So we need to do a second journal entry here. Interest expense, discount on notes payable. How much? The difference. 48 less 16. 32 amount on the account here. The discount on notes payable is closed. Or how do we double check this one? Double check 48 divided by 6 per month times 4 for a month. So we have here the 32. So it is a way to double check it. And another way is the discount on notes payable must be an ending balance of 0 or no ending balance. And now we pay our notes payable. So notes payable 500 and now cash $500,000. So the first one, we issue for cash and usually we have a discount, a interest rate. The second one, usually we are purchasing other asset that is not cash and we have no interest. However, we have the difference between cash price and credit price, and then the interest is the difference between both. Okay, guys, please subscribe our channel, like our Facebook page, Accounting Hub by Dr. Scarpin. If you have questions or comments, leave it here or email me at jscarpin@gmail.com. Have a very nice day. God bless you, and thank you for watching our video.